Welcome to an experience powered by Pipe TV.
Powered by Pipe TV.
Watching Pipe TV. I am your host, Ms. Tony. I am so happy that 2021 is behind us. It has left. I am not looking back, and I am here with you in 2022. Yes, hoping that everybody is definitely trying to improve on what happened last year just to make better of themselves, right? So I am so glad that we were able to catch up with one of our special guests today, and that is Dr. Bonita Best. We're gonna be talking with her and just chit-chat to find out where she was, what she's doing, and where she's going, right? She has beauty, brains, and she's an entrepreneur doing so many great things, loving to help and be an influencer in the community. So I am glad that she is here and stuck by Pipe TV to just chit-chat with us to see what's going on. So everyone, help me welcome my very special guest, Dr. Bonita Best. Yes, hi.
Be with you and yes. Happy New Year to you.
Yes, Happy New Year. Now, before we even, before I ask my first question, this is actually my first question. How do you like to be titled? Because you have the title of doctor, which we're going to talk about. So am I calling you Dr. Bonita Best, Dr. Best, Bo? What's going on? What name are we using?
Well, we're friends, so let's call me Bo. And that is the stage name that I accept and I answer to. I do answer to Dr. Bonita Best, Dr. Best, Dr. Bo. I've heard it all.
All the combinations.
Yeah. So, but on the runway, I am Bo the model. My friends from college and high school calls me Bo. But my family calls me Bonita. So I answer to those, but you can call me Bo.
All right, fantastic. So, Ms. Bo. All right. So, Bo, look, I told you guys, brains, beauty, and talent, that's what Bo has, right? So I just want everyone to get to know who Bo is. Like, where did you grow up? Where did you come from? Tell us.
Yeah, so I was born and reared in Tampa, Florida. So I'm a Floridian. While I was living there, people are like, you rarely see Floridians, but I was there. I grew up with my sister. I'm the oldest, and my father and my mother, they're still alive, thank God. So they are in Tampa. My entire family is in Tampa. I relocated to the DC metro area actually twice. Actually, technically three times.
Oh, just had to come back.
I just thought about it. My first time coming up here, I accepted a job right out of college as a programmer. I actually had a job waiting for me straight out of college. Actually, they wanted me to start when I was in my junior year because I finished everything.
Wow.
But due to me having a scholarship, you have to finish all 4 years. And so I waited until I graduated and came to DC. So that was number one. The second time I came up here, I relocated, and right before the 20, actually, the actually it was 2000 when I came, and I relocated up here. I was up here for 13 years, and then I moved back to Florida. And then I came back up here because now I'm pursuing modeling. And so I wanted to be close to the action, be close to New York, be close to Baltimore, where I've been. I was actually flying back and forth from Florida to do my castings. And I would not dare to say, oh, that's not a convenient time, to, for the
I
call
do
back.
travel. It's like, yes, not a problem.
Yeah, so there's like your call back is on this time and I'll fly back. And so I dropped a lot of money on airline tickets. So that's why I relocated back because I wanted to pursue this fully. And this is a dream, a childhood dream that I am pursuing.
Yes, and you do talk about childhood, and I have to go back to your childhood. So it's just you and your sister, correct? It's just you and your sister. And I remember in your bio that you sent, you actually said you had this reoccurring dream all the time. Help people help themselves.
That came to me when I was in elementary. I was a child and it was a recurring dream, and that message kept coming and I didn't know what it meant.
That's right.
And so at the time, I'm thinking, maybe that was my daycare that I went to because it was called Helping Hands. And so I thought it was, that particular, that message or something to that nature, but it wasn't because it kept coming to me. And what happens for me when I have dreams that's reoccurring, those are things that I have to take actions on. That is something that my parents and my grandparents told me. I have a gift, and and not to get too spiritual, too religious, but it's just something that have come to me and it's reoccurring is for me to take actions. It's for me
See,
to pursue.
Bo, it's funny that you said that, right? Well, it's not funny, but it's amazing that you said that because me too. From when I was young, I used to have these sayings or this vision over and over. And for you to be so young to even go to talk to your parents about, hey, look, I'm having this reoccurrence, and for them to help push you and pursue you towards following that and figuring that out. We're gonna talk more about that because that's where this next part of your life is actually created and occurring, right? So going into school, again, I did put that title before her name, Doctor. So it's coming up, guys. So I want you to stay tuned because there's so much more to Bo that you just look at her. You don't even know it's in there, but it's in there. Just stay tuned. We'll be right back with more Pipe TV.
Welcome to a new and exciting season of Pipe TV. You are now watching Pipe TV, where photography inside Plus magazine comes to life.
Welcome back. We are still here with Dr. Bo Best, again, better known as to all of, well, to me only, as Bo, right? So, Bo, welcome back. When we left out of here, we talked about this reoccurring vision, and I told you that that actually escalated and started to push you towards schooling. We are now in school with you. You did mention a little bit that you had scholarships, and basically, can you give us a little timeline on how you actually got to having the title as doctor? Because when people hear doctor, they think it's a medical doctor, right? So there's, yeah. So just give us a timeline of how schooling went for you.
Okay, so I love school. Love it, love it, love it. I was one of those kids, and I was in school all the time. I made
I would say anytime there was a summer break, I would go to summer school, not because I needed, you know, refresher courses or anything. It was because I love school. So I graduated with a lot of credits in high school. I had college credits in high school.
Right.
I was truly a student athlete, and I'm purposely stating student, then athlete, because I was very athletic. I was a cheerleader. I also ran track. I wanted a way out of the Tampa Bay area, and I figure either my brains are going to do it or my skills in running. And so actually both got me out of the Tampa Bay area. I secured a full scholarship at St. Augustine's University in Raleigh, North Carolina. And that's how I paid for my undergraduate. And from there, I pursued my career in the computer field, and I got my master's degree. I had an employer pay for it because I looked for employers. I wanted a way to not have to come out of pocket. And so I found an employer that would pay for my education. So they paid for my master's degree. And I continued to work. And by that time, I graduated, had my master's degree in technology management. So I'm still paying my student loans.
That's okay. That's an investment on you, right?
That's right. Yes, absolutely.
And I don't mean to go backwards for a minute, because I was, again, reading your bio, and I saw what you did your dissertation on.
Yes.
I was floored. I actually want to get my hands on it to read it, you know, if that's possible.
Yeah,
so
I can ship you one.
Yes, that would be awesome. Because guys, okay, so real quick, transferring tactic knowledge with the movement of people, like, this is a long title, guys. So I'm going to let you take that over, and really quick, give us a synopsis of what that dissertation was all about. Give us the title first.
So again, it's about people transferring knowledge, just like we're having a conversation. The information that is in our heads, which is tacit knowledge, is being transferred to you and transferred to the world because we are communicating. And my dissertation was about moving people or using technology to share information. I've also co-authored a book that's related to my dissertation, and that is to help people transfer information properly and successfully. And I came up with a model that is in my dissertation.
Correct. And you didn't only use people, you said employees.
Correct. People, employees. Absolutely. This is directed to the leadership to help them, especially when you're doing acquisitions, people buying companies, you need to transfer knowledge. And so let's say, for example, there's big computer companies that are moving offshore. They need to transfer that knowledge from people that's onshore to offshore. And how best to do it is transfer with people, not just sending a book. Something, you know, because that's stale. So it's the people that have that information.
Look at that. That just gives me the chills, because I'm also someone that loves learning. So when I saw that title, I was like, oh, I got to know more about this. It sounds very interesting. It actually is something that I could use in my 9-to-5 job, you know, get that information. So also cyber security. Really?
Yeah. And I want to say this. I got into the computer field because I wanted to be able to make money. And I did not want to have to go home or depend on my parents. And so that's why I got into this field. And at that time, we didn't have what we have today.
Correct.
And so I knew that I would always have a job. So either you get into the business of birthing babies, or putting people back to the earth. But computers is here to stay. And that's where I wanted to be.
And evolving.
I wanted to be able to be in demand at all times. So it has taken me outside of the United States to help companies and people in cybersecurity. And also everything that I do, it goes back to where my message, which is helping people help themselves. I'm helping companies, I'm helping people safeguard themselves from scammers, hackers, you know, those type of things. So that is, it's just perfect for me.
Okay, guys, look, there you go. The brains behind it all. And that's just the tip of it, because she has developed companies. She's a blogger. And I love the names of your company. Bold Knows Best, Bold Knows Cleaning, Bold Knows This, and Bold Knows That.
I mean, it's on purpose.
But it's so catchy and it's relatable. And, you know, again, I also mentioned about her being a model.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Well, guys, look no further, because we found a little clip of Bo as she did a runway. I'm not quite sure what location that is yet, but let's go ahead and take a quick peek at Bo taking her walk. Stay tuned.
This is Allison Williams Foster, and you are watching Pipe TV.
Drop in our lap? Like, what did I miss? What is going on? Where do you see yourself in the next 2 years? Tell us about your companies with the S. Because, yeah. You know, I know you have more than one company. Tell us all that. What's going on with you?
But I want to go back. I want to.
Okay.
Because I got into modeling late in life. I actually started modeling at 48. I'm 52 now.
No.
Yeah. So pursuing the dream, a childhood dream, it was everything for me. And so that's why I'm so aggressive, because one, I know this goes against traditional modeling, the fashion industry, you know, I'm short, I'm 5'6", I'm considered petite.
Yes.
But I'm walking with, you know, people that are 5'8", 6 feet, you know, or what have you, but I'm not letting that stop me. I'm pursuing it full on. And so that I wanted to make sure I emphasize that, because there's some people that may be listening that think that they can't pursue something.
Right.
You can pursue it, open the doors, create your way, and be you and follow your dreams. Be a dream catcher.
I'm actually, and you know, that's part of your hashtags. Yeah. I remember seeing that for you. Be a dream catcher. Absolutely. Yeah. Oh my gosh. Because you are that person that's a motivational speaker that inspires people as well. So thank you once again for sharing that. And going forward, what other jewels can you drop for people, please?
Well, I am going to be launching a podcast or a YouTube channel. I'm still kind of developing that, but I will be doing that. I'm going to be offering some model coaching, and my targeted audience will be, of course, all ranges, all ages, but I'm definitely looking at people that are over 30, because there are opportunities for us. There's things that I've learned. I am a freelance model. I do not have an agent, but I have negotiated with agents to negotiate opportunities that I found, and they have to serve as a middle person between them, like a commercial that I was in with Nike, as well as working with an agent for being a background extra for the Oprah Winfrey Network for David Makes Man. So I've had opportunities presented to me. I know how to negotiate, and that's where education comes into play. Mm-hmm. That's where you need to know, you know, have a business background, have education. Mm-hmm. So there's a lot more than beyond, you know, the the look. You yes. got a little bit more brains. There's more to what is on the surface.
And I agree with you. It's so very important, especially as you go to your different careers, to have the education, to have the knowledge. You know, I try... It's going to sound weird what I'm about to say, right? So I try not to push too much on education. The reason why is because not everybody could sit in that school setting. But you have to be knowledgeable, know where to get information from, and read up. And it's very important if you want to launch a career, especially being freelance, anything. You have to know your subject. You have to know your what's going on. So reading is very important to you know, look up and, you know, review and find all that information.
Right, right. And when I say education, it is the research. It is the due diligence. It's mm-hmm. not a traditional sitting in a classroom thing. Mm-hmm. I'm a nerd. I love school, but I don't push that on people. There's other ways. And those are the things that I do talk to some of my mentees, people that I'm coaching and et cetera, but there's other ways to learn and become educated. But what's next for me in the next few months to years is to continue to grow my business. I have a cleaning business, which is the Bonos Cleaning.
Yes.
And I am more of a boutique. I specialize in deep cleaning. So I do have commercial and residential clients. And
which is perfect now with all the COVID.
Oh, boy. Yes. Yeah. So
gotta be busy.
Oh yeah. So I am sometimes the cleaner, after the cleaners, sometimes, you know, I'm the person that will sometimes come in and say, okay, you have a regular cleaning, but I do deep cleaning. And so I do deep cleaning on top of what some of the
already done
buildings and et cetera. So I do that. The other thing is blogging. Blogging to me is an extension of my dissertation. It is me helping people help themselves mm-hmm. because I am developing a platform, a training platform that is going to be interactive with users or people wow. where they can learn more about, you know, cyber, how to, you know, protect their digital life, yeah. How to, you know, maybe get into the field because I am targeting women, people of color, but of course I'm open to whoever to get into,
right.
you know, into the field. But my target is people. I want to educate people. There's so much opportunity out here in cyber. Every company, small, big, across the world, there's opportunities out there.
Yes.
And I want people to tap into that. And there, you don't have to go to, you know, traditional school, right. majoring in computer science, technology, and all that stuff. Right. There's ways around it. And that's what I want to help people leverage what they currently know and apply it to cyber. And that is my niche. And that is what I'm working towards. And that's the platform that I'm developing.
Beautiful. And Bo, I always tell almost all my friends, my kids even, I'm like, you know, you all know computer. And they're looking at me like, what? I'm like, you have a cell phone. You know cell phones back in, yes!
Right.
Back in the days, what the cell phone used to do to what it could do now? Come yeah. on. I said, you'd be so smart. That is a computer.
And so we use it for other, you know, for other things, but honestly, there's so many things that we can do with this thing that we don't even need our device, our computers and et cetera, because it's right in the palm of our hands.
Correct.
We travel with it. And that's where scammers, hackers, and all that knows that they can get to us at any point because of this.
Yeah.
So that is something that I advocate for. I volunteer, I do the great American teach-ins because I talk about cyber. I talk about cyberbullying because bullying in person happens. It happens on the internet.
There's absolutely
human trafficking, same thing.
Absolutely.
So yes. I can go on and on. That's a whole yes. different conversation.
Well, look, you could go on and on, but in order for that to go on and on, I need for people to follow you so that they could call you and, you know, or look into you, and you could go on and on and find out how they could help. So please give us your social media or how they could reach you if possible.
Yeah. So for my cleaning business, that is Bow Nose Cleaning. And that's on Instagram as well as on Facebook. Also for me, Bonita Best, Dr. Bonita Best. I have, I'm Beau Best on Facebook, but I do have a professional model page that's on Facebook that is, you know, Beau the Model. And on Instagram is Beau _ the Model. There is another one out there, and it's just one underscore. So it's Beau _ the Model. And you'll see my bald head there.
Yes. By choice, Beau. By choice.
I am bald by choice. I've been this way since 96 before it became popular. Wow. And I've been maintaining this look because I want to, I did initially to get rid of, I was going through a divorce. And I shed my hair.
Oh, well, Beau, look, it's been such a pleasure. Oh my gosh. But guys, guess what? We are on Pipe TV. I'm your host, Miss Tony. And most of you already follow my other show, right? On the Move with Miss Tony. And Beau is going to be over there giving us some more insight, what's going on and whatnot. So make sure you look for On the Move with Miss Tony, featuring Beau Best, Dr. Bonita Best, okay? Yes, we're gonna use all her titles. All right, so, but Beau, again, thank you so much for coming through on Pipe TV. I appreciate you.
Oh, thank you for having, this is such an honor. I appreciate it, I'm grateful. Thank you so much.
Not a problem. Well, guys, gotta wrap it up. We gotta go. Again, find Beau there on the Move with Miss Tony. And until then, this is Pipe TV, your girl, Miss Tony. And it's been nice, and stay well, be safe, and I'll see you on another exciting episode of Pipe TV. See you guys. Bye.
Take care.